What's up, guys? I'm Daddy Gamer Fire back again with another E3 2017 reaction video. Now, in the EA conference, we had seen the initial teaser trailer for Anthem. Now, in the Xbox conference, we're going to be watching the gameplay video, the gameplay reveal of it. And everyone is fucking talking about it. They're saying that this shit is like Destiny on steroids. Let's see what the fuck they're talking about. Hey, John. Let me turn it up. Just a bit. There we go. Turn it up.
Hey!
Wow. Horizon vibes. Fuck Destiny. This shit looks beautiful. My god, is this a...
Freelancer.
Praxling.
Listen. Trouble.
Women character
Big
confirmed.
Trouble.
What did you do?
I made a mistake. I hired some people. They weren't freelancers.
Good faces.
They said they could handle it. And the price was right.
Good faces.
Maybe.
Unbelievable.
You're right. It was stupid. I'm sorry. But they're still out there. Somewhere.
Well,
if you could just bring them back. Anything you need.
Looks like that's what we're gonna be doing. A rescue mission. Oh. So they said this is a gameplay trailer, and it does look like it said everything is in-game.
You and your friends are freelancers, the heroes who leave the safety of the walls of Fort Tarsus to explore the unknown and protect humanity. Let's join two players as they head out on an expedition.
Hey, Paul. You ready to go?
We're just grabbing some supplies. Just about ready.
What are you going to use today?
I decided to go with the Colossus.
I'm going to use my Ranger. Try out some new upgrades.
Advanced warfare type vibes. Don't tell me we're gonna go into space. Titanfall. Shit. Yes, definitely Titanfall vibes. Yes.
Every player will own an array of exosuits we call javelins.
Okay.
These suits give players superhuman capabilities. And are heavily customizable, so they look and play how you want.
Okay. Shit.
Damn, looking good. Nice, you've got a mortar equipped.
Yeah, I got it on the weekend. Lead the way, I'll follow.
Whoa. No loading screen, just jump right in. I like that. Okay, deep diving. Flying through with the jetpack? I like this.
This is a vast open world you explore with your friends.
Okay.
Each javelin exosuit has its own unique playstyle. The Ranger is balanced and all purpose, while the Colossus is a tanking powerhouse.
We've seen.
Right. Let's see what's up here.
The world of Anthem is hostile, and threats can come from any direction. It's a dynamic world where the unexpected is around every corner.
Oh my god.
I'm not sure we want to use all our supplies on this guy.
Yeah, he seems like a problem for another day.
Oh my god. This shit is nuts.
I'll go low. You flank.
Oh my god. If they didn't shot. Oh my fucking god. Shit. He fucking went underwater. Why? Why? What the fuck was shooting at them? Oh my fucking god. There we go. Go first.
Hang in there. Almost there.
Okay. Gears of War S type 5 with the shooting.
We should do that later with Kim.
Yeah, he could use the XP. Hello, treasure.
Wait, so this is not in-game dialogue? This is not like, it's like multiplayer. I see why they said this is like Destiny. Okay, I'm getting that. I'm getting that. There's two people talking to each other who's playing the game. Not just in-game characters, which I thought it was.
Anyone in the area, we're under attack.
I think that's part of Praxis' mission.
Alright. shit.
Equip your Javelin exosuit with gear that brings devastating power to combat.
Oh my god.
Oh, there are a lot of scars down there. Oh, the scars have a heavy.
Time to use that mortar.
Oh my fucking god.
Give me some covering fire. There's a bunch more coming in.
Okay, I'll get this round.
Oh, stop it. No. Fucking Iron Man. What? No, that was cool. That was cool. That was cool. Oh, he stole that from Iron Man, but it was good. Cool.
Luke. Yes, Jair's wrath.
Oh, nice.
She was too excited.
Large-scale world events like Shaper Storms are dynamic and pull you off the beaten path with the promise of new stories to discover.
Oh, Shaper Storm incoming. Okay, actually, let's get some more people. Hold on a sec.
Hey guys, what's up?
Adding more people to the party. Let's go! Four player team, man. Let's go. This is gonna be fucking epic though, man. Look at this shit. Oh my fucking god.
Whoa.
Power this Xbox X, man.
This storm is getting crazy.
This shit looks beautiful, bro.
So what are we supposed to do? Fly into him?
That's exactly what you should do.
Alright, let's do this.
See you on the other side.
Stop it, man. This shit looks fucking
good. Our story is out there.
Round of a fucking applause, bruh. Oh my god. Let's. I'm gonna rewind that again. Like always, I'm gonna stop. Let me use the fucking mouse. I'll stop the audio and. Now, for a trailer, a gameplay reveal trailer, I gotta say, this is probably the best gameplay reveal trailer I've seen for a long time. This whole E3, I think the best gameplay reveal trailer before, I would have to say Battlefield 2, but even that one was, we know what Battlefield fucking 2 looks like. Like, we've seen the cinematic trailer, the story trailer, and we've been playing Battlefield 1 for a fucking while. Like, we know this is beautiful. This is a new IP from BioWare, the people that made Mass Effect, not Andromeda. That was the B team. This is the A team. And my God, you could see that they were hard at fucking work, making this. And I tell you the truth, I am down. I am down. After seeing the reveal trailer, I was kind of like, I gotta see more. Yes, I'm fucking down. This shit looks fucking exactly what I was told. They said it was, yo, this is Destiny on steroids. Yes, this is Destiny on steroids. What I mean by that is this is a game that we're going to be playing with our friends, playing multiplayer, doing missions, getting loot, exploring this vast open world. And hopefully that's what this, experiences. I'm hoping that that's what this game is gonna do, a Destiny-esque style game, and I'm open for that. Even if it's not, this game, let me just get it out the way, it looks beautiful. Probably the best looking game I've seen so far during this E3. This is before the Sony press conference, so I didn't see the Sony press conference. It's tonight though. Yeah, there we go. It's tonight though. I'm really hoping that this game comes out on PS4, so I want to fucking buy Xbox One to play this, but shit, this shit looks good. Besides that, it looks good, it sounds good, it looks like it feels good, and that's very, very good thing. In the trailer, you don't really get to the sense of like feeling like this game is good, but just by looking at this trailer, you feel like it was a good experience to play this, and that's what made it real jolly. It showed a little bit of action sequences that, you know, he left one act on one monster in particular he didn't want to deal with, went up to another group of monsters, attacked them with various of weapons, which all looked dope. The Iron Man shit when he shot the whole bunch of missiles up, even the shotgun up close, was pretty dope. I'm loving it. I could see tons of hours getting wasted running around this world, especially with a group of people. This game is going to be, we're going to be talking about this game for a while on this channel, if you didn't notice. So, you guys know how these goes. You see my initial reaction, you get my thoughts, and then I want to hear from you guys. I want to know what you guys thought of the trailer, what else you guys want to see from Anthem, and what do you guys want to see in the next trailer from Anthem. I think I want to see story. We've seen gameplay. We've seen how beautiful you could swim underwater. This avatar-looking world, we've seen it. Now explain to us why. Why are we this character? Why do we need to know this story? I think that would tie everything together in the game. Now, Destiny, if it's just on the limb of the idea of it being a Destiny-style game. Now, if it is like Destiny, and Destiny 1 story was trash, and then it was almost non-existent. I mean, they did bring in DLC that brought in the story, but EA, please, don't follow the steps in Destiny. Follow the steps in the Mass Effect, where as far as you bring a good story in. You guys did that in Mass Effect 1. You kind of did it. You did it in 2 and 3, kind of messed up the ending, but we got faith in you guys. Besides that, I just want to see more of it. So, I'm Daddy Gamer Fred on Instagram and Twitter. You can hit me up on those with trailers or whatever you want me to cover, and I'll see if I can get to them. I'm going to be doing a ton of these videos here on YouTube, on this channel, and the best way you can see them all is with the subscription. You can hit the subscribe button, and you can keep up with me as far as me doing all of these trailer reaction videos. This game right here is tempting to pull the trigger on that $500 Xbox, but I'm gonna hold it off just in case it comes to the PS4. And if it comes to the Switch, nah, I doubt it. But let's see. This shit is good. This shit, I'm not gonna lie. This shit looks fucking amazing. It looks like it plays amazing. Let's just hope that the story is worth sticking around for. I'm Daddy Gamer Fred, the American Gamer in Switzerland, and I see you guys on the next one.